I mean, Republicans in Michigan actually have always been fairly liberal up until this recent era. And now, you know, there's really two Michigans. I think this is something that people need to understand. I don't mean just the lower peninsula and the upper peninsula. I mean, there's the Michigan that is has this long history of populism, the union movement, the Flint sit-down strike 75 years ago this month. Got the UAW their first industry-wide contract. So, you know, there's a lot of, you know, that really is the majority of Michigan. There's this other part of Michigan, though, and especially on the west side and a lot in the northern part of the state, which is where I live, up in this red part of the state, that always seems very upset at what the majority of us are doing. They don't like the liberal Senator Levin or the liberal Congressman Conyers, or it's just all too liberal for them, and they hate Detroit and Flint, and they moved out of there to get as far away sometimes as they can from these areas that they don't particularly care for. And I think this is why Santorum is probably doing so well with them, because it's a very, I mean, just to give you the sort of schizophrenic nature of the state, you know, it's the state that you know, it's the union movement began there. It's also the state of Father Coughlin, the right-wing anti-Semitic radio preacher during, you know, before World War II. It's the school district next to mine is where Terry Nichols went to school, who was the participated in the Oklahoma City bombing. Tim Tebow, the Boston goalie who snubbed President Obama, wouldn't go and meet with the rest of the players with him. He and I went to the same high school.
The Bruins. Yeah.
So that high school produced me and him. So that is Michigan.
So you're saying that rather than thinking of Michigan as a state that is any one thing, because if you can have a conservative state that gives you kind of a specific kind of conservative politics, but if you've got a state that's got a lot of liberal populism in it, you end up with kind of a combative form of conservatism among
yes.
the Republicans?
Yes, and that, in fact, that swings sometimes way to the right.
Yeah.
Because it's trying
they're,
to fight.
They're afraid.
It's trying to fight this nucleus of liberal thinking in America that is very much a part of Michigan's history.